to Latest TV. My name is Val Aviv. Brighton, home to 200,000 people. An ordinary day in Brighton, but is there such a thing?
I drink all night and I sleep all day. I drink all night and I sleep all day.
Here with me at the zombie parade is Bender. Bender, what are you doing here?
Bite my shiny metal ass.
Thank you. Nutrition wise, if a zombie did not have any brains to eat, what could they eat as an alternative?
Brains.
Rocks, girlfriend.
I'm sorry?
Take two fabrics.
We've been rotting together for about 8 years now.
That is beautiful. I would just pay anything to know what she's thinking right now. What are you thinking right now? What are they going to do when the brains run out? Because, ladies and gentlemen, there's so many zombies and not enough brains in Brighton.
Brains.
They eat a lot of brains, but they're not very communicative. There's no hope for us here in Brighton if Indiana Jones didn't make it.
Equality.
Do you think that zombies have been discriminated against when trying to get jobs within the NHS?
I was discriminated against.
Why was that? What did you do?
I tried to eat their brains.
I just wanted to know what foundation you're using.
Brains.
Just brains?
Brains.
What foundation did you use? Can I get that in boots? If I want to be a zombie, right, do I have to be dead? I can see you've been stabbed. How do I kill a zombie?
In the head.
In the head?
Brains.
So you managed to make it into England, Pope. Have you been enjoying your visit?
It's been lovely. So many brains.
It's lovely to see you like this.
It's been great to visit. Your children taste beautiful.
Thank you, it means a lot. Word on the street, ladies and gentlemen, is that Brighton Dance Flash Mob are actually here and it's all gonna go down. Home to 253,300 people and a million zombies!
Pretend to eat them.
Marking the end of the British summer, the White Night Festival illuminates the skies of Brighton. Our latest reporter, Natalie Pottinger, brings you more on the event.
As many as 120 cities around the world host an annual White Night event. It's not actually certain which city started it all off, with the White Night Festivals dating back over 200 years. Whole cities turn into free-for-all public art galleries where any artist can freely display their art. Tonight is Brighton's third annual White Night Festival, the one night that Brighton's museums, private and public art galleries and cultural institutions open their doors free of charge and let the whole city celebrate art. We're here now with Jamie Wild from from Divine Passage, and he's going to give us a little peek into the meaning behind all this. I mean, it is very curious.
We decided to create these spaces that you could think about and explore sexual identity and gender. And then here at Lighthouse, we've got some films. One of the films is by Stuart Sanford called Penis Pokey.
Quite interesting, I must say. Divine Passage. Jelliot, he's the man with the vision, might we say, behind this UFO creation. Tell us a little bit more about your creation.
It's called Anti-Gravity. A background as a sculptor, so I'm trying to make a sculptural object that comes alive through animation. And I just thought, well, wouldn't it be nice to go up high? And I just kind of started to put ideas together and thought about, well, I can suspend it from a crane, I can put a projector in a crane, and I can make whatever we see float up in the sky above people's heads.
Do you believe that the government is suppressing information of the existence of UFOs?
No, absolutely not.
You don't?
No, no.
Make sure you put this event on your calendar to be held every year the last Saturday of October when the clocks go back, marking the end of the British summer.
Latest TV rocks!
Yay!
I can't do this for the rest of my life!
Welcome to the latest offices. We're here to find out what's going on this week, and here to tell us is Andrew Kay, the theatre editor for Latest 7. Andrew, tell us.
Lots of one-nighters in Brighton and around Sussex this week, but the real thing to be doing is booking a Christmas show.
Right, I'm gonna get on it right now, but what do you recommend?
I would recommend in Brighton Cinderella. It's a new musical version, less pantomime, no soap stars, fantastic. Chichester, Alice in Wonderland, and up at the Hawth in Crawley, Craig Revel Horwood is playing the Wicked Queen. That's not to be missed.
Have you ever played a Wicked Queen?
I have, I'm afraid. I was in a pantomime a few years ago.
I can really imagine it. Well, thank you very much, Andrew. And now to tell us all about what's going on in the world of music in Brighton this week, I'm with Jeff Hemmings, musical editor. So tell us what's going on.
I would say Caitlin Rose, who's a Nashville, 23-year-old Nashville girl, coming to the Comedia for another gig 2 months after a previous one. It's going to be brilliant.
Thank you very much, Jeff. We'll be catching up with you next week. Here with me now, Vicky Nangle, here to tell us about what's going on in the world of comedy in Brighton.
Hello. We've got some fantastic stuff. On Wednesday, there's the Funnier Farm, which is on at the Caroline of Brunswick, a really lovely little venue. And unfortunately, Funnier Farm is coming to the end at the end of this year, so there's only 3 more shows. You've got to make sure you catch them because they are brilliant and it's such a shame it's stopping. But this next one on Wednesday has got Danielle Ward headlining, who wrote... She co-wrote Gutted, the Revenges musical, which was a runaway success up in Edinburgh. So make sure you catch her this Wednesday. On Sunday, a new thing is starting. As one thing finishes, another starts. Knock to Bag, a booking agency in London.
Knock to Bag.
Knock to Bag. They're about to have some spin-offs. We'll tell you more about that when they come about.
Can't wait to find out.
Well, Knock to Bag are down at Brighton Ballroom, and they've got a brand new show, and headlining is Angelus Epithemios.
Okay.
You know the fella from Shooting Stars with the plastic bag? Yeah, him. He'll be headlining down there, and there is a special mystery guest.
And here with me now, events editor for the latest, Zara Baker. Hello, Zara. Tell us top 2 things that are going on this week.
Right, well, I'm really looking forward to the My Swish Clothes-Swap, an event that takes place at the Lansdowne Place Hotel this Sunday.
I love a good clothes swap.
It's going to be really good fun. A small entry fee, and you can get a whole new wardrobe out of it.
Excellent. Sounds good to me. So tell us, what else is going on? Biggest event.
Really looking forward to the Royal Pavilion Christmas Ice Rink. That opens up this Saturday. There we're launching it with an ice ball on the Friday night, where you can enjoy a festive three-course meal and some skating at the same time.
I love a bit of ice skating. I love it all. Thank you very much. Well, that's all from us here at The Latest. If you want to know everything that's going on in town, there are fully comprehensive listings at thelatest.co.uk. So check it out. Get your skates on.
New word from the nation's top scientists on the zombie virus that appeared just 2 weeks ago. They released information saying that the symptoms to watch for are aggression, foaming from the mouth, deterioration of organs.